Hey everyone, it's Artea. Not too long ago, the Elder Scrolls Online's Twitter account posted this tweet about how respec scrolls are on sale in the Crown Store. For those who don't know, the Crown Store is the premium currency store. You purchase crowns with real-life money to be able to spend on certain items in the game. These items are primarily cosmetic, but there have been a few services that you can purchase now that offer convenience, like skill lines, sky shards, and likewise skill points, and more. You can also purchase DLCs through the Crown Store. This tweet caused quite the commotion in the ESO community. The hashtag ESOFam, as some may call it, because respecs can actually be done with in-game gold, and hardly any of it to be honest, rather than premium currency, aka real-life money. In fact, with the introduction of the armory system, respecs can arguably be done for free in some instances. All you'd need to do is port to one of your homes, place the free armory furnishing, and interact with it. This has honestly been a blessing, especially for those of us that like to PvP and PvE on the same characters. Now to be clear, I'm not here to shit on Zoss or add my take on this whole situation. I feel as if this conversation has since been terminated anyways, and a lot of people have already voiced their opinions on this predicament. Advertising a means to pay real money for a service that can be done for free, that is. I know that Sawman likes to be a bit of a shitter with his content, but he honestly was speaking straight facts in his video addressing the situation. Go check out his video if you want to hear an opinionated rant, because every time I share an opinion on here, I get destroyed in my comment section and in various Discord servers. So I'll live vicariously through him. But something that was glaring to me from watching Sawman's video was how the creative director of Zoss suggested in one of his streams that, and mind you, I am paraphrasing here, players of course didn't have to buy the respec scrolls if they didn't want to, but that they're there on the Crown Store for convenience. He went on to suggest that finding out about the possibility to respec for free or for gold is very simple to do, and that people just don't read. I totally get what he means when he says that people can't read, man. Like, I run a Discord server, okay? Enough said. But truthfully, a lot of information about ESO really isn't readily available in-game. I remember when I was a newer player. This is the first MMO that I've ever played as well, so this was all very overwhelming for me. A lot of the information that I came to learn, I learned from friends that I made while playing, or ESO content creators. New players may not even be aware of the fact that there is a possibility to respec for gold or for free in the game, so how would they know to look for it? Seeing a respec scroll in the Crown Store or on Twitter may be the first instance that they've ever even heard about the notion of respecing. It took me a solid month of playing the game at my own pace before I even discovered a capital city, let alone the rededication shrines located in them. Furthermore, the creative director suggested that for some people, making a lot of gold is really difficult, which is why they aim to implement these alternatives that cost real-life money in the Crown Store. Of course, I'm hoping to try to fix this whole gold is hard to make mentality by helping people find ways to make gold in the game that work best for them and what they enjoy doing when they play ESO. But regardless of how you choose to make gold, or even if you choose to put any effort towards making gold in ESO or not, it is important to take note of the fact that a respec at a shrine costs actual peasant change. You'd pick up enough gold to respec just from playing for a little bit and selling your crap to the merchant, no sweaty trading required. And again, you can respec for free via the armory system. So the suggestion that some people may not be able to afford these respecs in-game was pretty misleading. Gold ain't that hard to come by, and this service in particular is technically free in some cases anyways. This entire situation made me consider just how many players may not know about these items and services that can be offered or attained for free. And by free, I mean it would literally cost you nothing, or at worst, it would cost you some gold, which is the in-game currency of ESO that you earn from playing the game and selling things to merchants or other players through the Trading Guild system. So I figured I would try to do my part and use my platform to try to educate players on the kinds of items that you can buy for real money in the Crown Store that can be obtained for free through the game. Without further ado, let's get into it. Starting with the hot topic itself, respecs can be done at the rededication shrines in any major city. Oftentimes, these shrines are located in a church-like building or at a shrine for maximum roleplay immersion. At these shrines, you can change your morphs, like if you want to spec from stamina to magicka, or you can change your skills entirely by moving all of the skill points that you've collected around. You can also change your attributes. All of these respecs cost a bit of gold that scales with the amount of skill points that you've collected on that character. You can also interact with the armory to change between entire loadouts that even include CP, which is really handy. Fortunately, you don't have to pay real money for Twilight ERP. If you go to a werewolf, or a vampire shrine, players that are already infected will have the chance to bite you. If they do, then you'll contract their disease. If you're in a guild, you can oftentimes just ask in guild chat if anyone would be willing to give you a werewolf or a vampire bite. Guildies will usually do this for free. I've personally bitten about 10 TTS guildies, for example. Ooh woo. You could also ask for a bite in zone chat, although you are more likely going to have to pay the person offering a bite some gold if you do this. You may also see the occasional advert in zone chat from a person willing to sell a bite for a bit of gold. A far less favorable alternative is to contract vampirism or lycanthropy from NPCs. Lycanthropy? How do you say that? To get infected with vampirism, you'd have to be attacked by unique blood fiend enemies that can spawn in Reaper's March, Bankrai, and the Rift. Although they don't spawn every night, and you aren't guaranteed to be infected upon being damaged. To get infected with the furry disease, you'd have to be attacked by unique werewolf enemies that also only spawn on certain nights in certain locations. Much like the case with vampirism. Because of how tedious this last method is, a lot of people tend to just ask guildies or friends for a bite. Fortunately, it is a pretty common practice to give bites out. Storage coffers are super convenient, and I'd highly recommend getting some of these to place in your homes to then be able to store items so as to alleviate some of the space in your bank. Finally, a place to hold all of these. Your best bet is to do some master writs and use some of your vouchers that you'd get from doing so to then buy them from the master writ vendors located in every Alliance capital city. I suppose I can understand the desire to purchase riding lessons. No one likes being this slow. Please, my grandmother walks faster than this and she's literally crippled. If you'd like to level up your mount speed and inventory and carrying capacity in-game, you can only do so once per character per day. Even then, I'd say it's worth it to just be patient. Especially when riding lessons from the Crown Store cost this much. God damn, looks like we're having sleep for dinner tonight with those prices, boys. But food and potions and scrolls, those can absolutely be purchased for gold in-game. You can buy these wares from guild traders located in bigger cities, in small towns, in the middle of nowhere, and even in outlaws. Refuges. Obligatory and in your mom's house joke. You can also learn to make your own food and potions, something that I'd advise doing on your main tune, your crafter if you will. In order to learn how to make foods and drinks, you need to first level up your provisioning skill line and read the recipe for the item that you want to make. Read it once and you're good to go. You can always craft that recipe on that tune at any time, provided you're at a provisioning station and have the necessary ingredients and are at a high enough provisioning level to do so. As for crafting potions and poisons, you can level up your alchemy skill line and use certain combinations of alchemical ingredients to create all kinds of poisons and potions. Experience scrolls are a little more tricky to craft. They require costly ingredients, and the recipes themselves can be tricky to attain. However, you'll find that you actually accrue quite a bunch of these scrolls just by logging in on a regular basis, because of how frequently they're used as daily rewards. If you're an average Twitch enjoyer, you can also receive the occasional free Ouroboros crate whenever Twitch drops are on just from watching ESO streamers. These crates oftentimes reward you with these very items, so there's no need to pay real money for them. You can purchase pre-made dye combinations in the Crown Store. The assortment of purchasable dyes tends to change every once in a while. A vast majority of these dyes can actually be attained for free from completing various achievements in the game. That's why fashion is endgame, after all. Once you've played for a little while, you'll unlock quite an array of dyes and will have no need to purchase them for real money. Although some dyes are Crown exclusive, like this one pearlescent white that comes out during the holidays, and this one beautiful gold that comes out during the Jester's Festival. That's the only time I've ever purchased a dye, although perhaps if you like a specific combination and couldn't be asked to complete an achievement, I could see how you'd want to buy one for crowns. On the topic of fashion, I think it's also worth mentioning that you don't need to buy an outfit change token anytime you want to change your outfit. You can just use your gold to do so. Speaking of endgame, a lot of houses can also be purchased with gold once you've completed the necessary achievements needed in order to unlock this option. These achievements are quest-related, so they're fairly accessible by all players, fortunately. And to finish off this holy trinity of the true ESO endgame experience, the motifs that are available in the Crown Store can be attained by running content, such as daily quests in DLC zones, or from completing veteran DLC dungeons. Likewise, you can purchase these motifs from other players through the Guild Trader system. Research scrolls can come in quite handy when you're looking to speed up your research timers when crafting, so that you may learn to make gear in multiple traits. This normally takes a fair amount of time, so using research scrolls can definitely help speed up this process. You can purchase research scrolls with writ vouchers, which you get from completing master writs. You also get a fair amount of these from daily login rewards as well. These scrolls that come from the master writ vendors can only be used on cooldown, to be fair, whereas there's no cooldown on the scrolls that come from the crown store, so do keep that in mind. These scrolls function like the Kolovian war torts, in the sense that if you consume one, you will gain alliance rank quicker than usual, and subsequently increase your alliance war skill lines in a faster manner. Instead of buying these crown scrolls, you have the option of purchasing torts, or even learning how to craft them yourself. Although, of course, like experience scrolls, that is a bit of a pricey endeavor. It's possible to purchase Sorrel horses in-game. I'd recommend grabbing one of these bad boys to serve as your noble steed until you have the means to get a fancier looking mount. You can even get this neat ebon wolf for free via the antiquities system. And that's about it. Of course, I'm not one to tell anyone how they should spend their real life money. If you want to go ahead and purchase these items for crowns, I say you should go for it. But for those who may be newer to the game and may not be aware that there is any other alternative besides paying real money for these items, I hope that this video has been able to clarify that for you. I'd recommend saving those crowns to spend on items that you can't get just from playing the game alone, like the neat outfits or hairstyles or the new dungeon arms packs that come out each month. And of course, to tie this back to what prompted me to make this video, let's please not send Zoss any hate. Voicing your opinion is entirely valid and reasonable, and I do hope that the devs realize that we're voicing our concerns not because we're spiteful, or that we can't read or what have you, but because we're just trying to look out for the newer players that may mistakenly spend real life money when they don't need to. An experience that I'm sure can't be all that pleasant when they find out that what they did was unnecessary, and arguably, an experience that some of us have endured in the past as well. I know that I, for example, bought a default mount for real money because I didn't know that you could buy yourself a horse with gold, and I just wanted to be able to move around from one place to another quickly. When I found out about the Sorrel horses that can be bought for gold and how you have a chance to get even cooler mounts from crates or with your crown gems, I was definitely disappointed. I'd hate for too many unpleasant experiences like this to dissuade newer players from coming back to the game. And I can see how advertising these crown services and crown items could promote this. So I think that voicing your opinion is fine, but let's keep it at that and not be unnecessarily mean to the devs, yeah? Alright, that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching, and thank you to my YouTube members for the additional support. I will see you in the next video. Cheers! So beautiful. Sometimes I stop and close my eyes.